But see, that wish is so. My cousin, Westmoreland. No, my fair cousin. Wish not a man from England. God's peace. If we are marked to die, we are enough to do our country laws. And if to live, well, the fewer men, the greater share of honor. God's will, I pray thee wish not one man more. By Jove, I am not covetous for gold. It yearns me not if men my garments wear, nor care I who doth feed upon my cost. But if it be a sin to covet honor, well, then I am the most offending soul alive. Rather proclaim at Westmoreland throughout this host that he that hath no stomach for this fight, let him depart. His passport will be made, and crowns for convoy put into his purse. We would not die in that man's company that fears his fellowship to die with us. This day, it's called the Feast of Crispian. He that outlives this day and comes safe home will stand a tiptoe when this day is named, and rouse him at the name of Crispian. He that shall see this day and reach old age will yearly on the vigil feast his neighbors and say, tomorrow is Saint Crispian. Then will he strip his sleeves and show his scars and say, these wounds I had on Crispin's day. Old men forget, yet all shall be forgot. But he'll remember with advantages what feats he did that day. Then shall our names familiar in his mouth as household words, Harry the King, Bedford and Exeter, Warwick and Talbot, Salisbury and Gloucester shall be in their flowing cups freshly remembered. This story shall the good man teach his son, and Crispin Crispianus shall ne'er go by from this day until the ending of the world, but we in it shall be remembered. With you, we happy. Few, we band of brothers. For he that sheds his blood today with me shall be my brother, be he ne'er so vile. This day shall gentle his condition, and gentlemen in England now a bed shall think themselves a curse they were not here with us, and hold their manhoods cheap, whilst any speaks that fought with us upon St. Crispin's Day.
Minutes.
I have to say, I would follow a king like that. I would go and kill. I would get killed. How many of you guys are there? I don't have too much to add to that.
It was wonderful. Because when you've done it before, it's always been, I want to run the other way because of the intensity. This, you sucked me in. Mm-hmm. And like he said, sign me up. Sign me up. It's beautiful. By the way, he's probably not even aware of it, but he knows how to use commas. Well, he knows what to do with commas. Or he doesn't even think about it, but he knows how to relish a line and stop. And then continue. And that's when you're really on top of shit. Did you count the commas? Did you know where the comma was? No.
No, because after a while, it gets instinctive.
It's instinctive,
and you go through the whole idea.
And you even with once you get the idea, you can stop and
play with it.
Yeah.
And then you can play with it, which you did.
Yeah, which you did. Which you did. Yeah, the default when you're first studying is don't do commas, just talk.
Yeah.
And then you'll get the feeling of it. And then that's what I mean by really experienced Shakespeare, who will know how to use commas. Or we know what to do with comics, or you know, whatever.
Ultimately, somebody like a Richard Burton breaks all the rules. he was taught by a man, Philip Burton, who knew the rules and who adopted it. And then once he learned the rules and had a feeling for it, by the way, he did a Caliban.
I've seen it years ago. It's phenomenal. I just ordered it from Amazon.
But
I'm waiting.
But he, when he played Hamlet, he was breaking every rule. And he was running through periods. And he could do it because his mind was a little Taylor. And well, they didn't come to see him. They came to see Taylor. But he was great. But once you have a feeling for doing this kind of stuff, then you play with it. Then you really play with it. And you don't worry too much about all the rules. Nice to know them. And then,
I don't know if it's playing with it. It's more just feeling this incredible, these words. Just feeling it and giving it to us.
Carlos, come on up. And what do you have? Do you have any in the house?
Huh?
You